Hello friends, I am Rajaneesh Chandran. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this particular video, we are going to discuss about the introductory topics in projection of lines. So in the previous video, we have plotted 9 different points, or we have projected 9 different points in space in HP and VP. Or we have learned about the what is front view, what is a top view, or what is elevation and plan of a point. How the points can be plotted above the HP, below the HP, in front of VP, as well as behind VP. In this particular video, we are going to study about the introductory topics regarding projection of lines. So, what is a line? A line means it is a shortest distance between two points, right? So, suppose we have two points, and if this is the shortest distance between these two points, then this can be, or this locus can be taken as the line connecting these two endpoints. So, what will be the projection of the lines? Simple, projection of the line means, see, this is a point, this is another endpoint, this point will have two projections, it's a front view as well as it's a top view, this point also have two projections, it's front view as well as it's a top view. So the projection of the line can be obtained by connecting the front views of the endpoints as well as the top views of the endpoints, right? If you are connecting the front views of the endpoints, we will get the front view of the line, and if you are connecting the top views of the endpoints, we will get the top view of the line. Is it clear? So, for learning how to project a line in HP and VP, we have to by heart or we have to learn certain rules. The rules are, assume this is a line, and this line, assume this line is parallel to VP. Now this line is parallel to VP, right? See, now this line is parallel to VP. So we know that in orthographic projection, observer are at infinity. So when he is observing this line, since this line is parallel to VP, he can see the entire length of this line. Is it clear? Since this line is parallel to VP, he can see the entire length of this line. See, this entire length means, suppose this line is having 30 cm. That 30 cm is known as the true length or original length of this line. True length or original length of this line. So, when this line is parallel to VP, the observer can see the true length of this line. That is a rule. So, when a line is parallel to one of the reference points, or when a line is parallel to VP, the observer can see the true length of this line. See, now what happened? Now, I tilted this line with an angle with VP, right? What you are seeing? You are observing that the length of this line is diminishing or shortening, right? See, in this video, in this position, you can see the true length of this line. You can see the 30 cm, but what will happen now? The line is diminishing, right? What will happen? Why it is shortening? Because what you are observing is, this point will be projected here, this point will be projected here, and this length is your watch, you are observing. So, now, this was the length, and when it is rotating like this, or when it is tilting like this, and this projection is moving along like this, so that this will be diminishing like this. So, from that point, what we have understood is, when a line is parallel to one of the reference planes, the projection of the line on that plane will show the true length, that is a rule. So, when a line is parallel to one of the reference planes, the projection of the line on that plane will show true length. Now suppose, in the same position, in this position, you can see the true length as this line is parallel to VP. When you are observing from top, you can see this distance as well as this distance, right? Since the line is parallel to VP, this distance and this distance will be equal. Which means, in the top view, this point will be projected to HP, this point will be projected to HP, and since this distance and this distance is equal, that projection or that line will be a line parallel to X-ray. Is it clear? Because see, this is the line, and when you are observing from the top, see, now this is a parallel to VP, and when you are observing from top, this point will be projected here, this point will be projected here, and you can see something like this. Because since it is parallel to VP,
this distance and this distance will be same, so that you can see in the top view you can see something like this. So that this line will be parallel to XY line. This line will be parallel to XY line and of shorter length.
So how can we combine these two things? When a line is parallel to one of the reference lines, the projection of the line on that plane will show true length, and the projection of the line on the opposite plane will be a line parallel to XY of shorter length. This is the point. So I'll explain again. When a line is parallel to one of the reference planes, the projection of the line on that plane will show true length, and the projection of the line on the opposite plane will be a line of shorter length parallel to XY. I think all of you have understood this. We can expand this rule like this. See, when a line is parallel to VP, the projection of the line on VP or the front view will show the true length, and the projection of the line on HP or the top view will be a line parallel to XY of shorter length. Similarly, when a line is parallel to HP, the projection of the line on HP or the top view will show the true length, and the projection of the line on HP or the front view will be a line of shorter length and parallel to XY line. These are the two rules. And one more rule is there. The rule is, when a projection opposite to this rule, when a projection is parallel to XY line, its opposite projection will be true length. What we have learned is, when a line is parallel to one of the reference planes, the projection of the line on that plane will show true length, and the opposite plane will have a parallel to XY line of shorter length. So when a projection is parallel to XY line, its opposite projection will be of true length. See, these are the three important rules that you have to understand, and by applying these rules in the questions, we can solve any problems in projection of lines of engineering. So I hope all of you have understood. In this video we have learned about the introductory topics in projection of lines, and in the next video we will be studying projection of lines parallel to both HP and VP. So I hope all of you have understood. Thank you.